I mean, I would never suggest Brooklyn if I didn't think that she would be great for business.
I thought about having music at the Metro Court if the right singer came along.
Well, then you should at least audition Brooklyn. I mean, Dante heard her at Jake's and he said that she's awesome.
Wow. Well, I just saw Brooklyn earlier and she never mentioned needing a singing job. What makes you think she wants to stick around Port Charles?
Brooklyn wants to stick around. She just needs a job.
With all that quarter main money.
It doesn't hurt to work for a living.
Nope. Everyone has the right to earn money doing what they do well.
I mean, honestly, it would be perfect. Not just for Brooklyn, but for you and for the hotel, for the Quartermains. You know, Edward's totally torn up about everything that's going on with Michael. It might be nice for him to have Brooklyn around.
Right. This will help Edward.
I'm sorry. That didn't come out right. Amazing would it be to have live talent a couple nights a week at the hotel? Supper clubs are very retro.
Wow, you picked the wrong career. You should have been a talent agent. Tell Brooklyn to call me. I'll discuss everything with her. Unless you want to sit in on the negotiations.
No, stop. I honestly, this is great. You're not going to be sorry.
Haven't said yes, but I will keep an open mind. Bye.
Thanks. Something smells amazing.
We were totally gonna wait for you, but then
the pasta actually, it cooked too quickly.
I told her that this thing, for some reason, the stove cooks way faster. I don't know why.
I really didn't want it to get mushy, so I served it. I hope that's okay.
No, of course. I mean, I'm the one who's late. I actually ran into Carly on the way over here. How's that for coincidence?
Wow. Did you say anything?
I might have mentioned that Dante thinks you're a rockin' singer and she should hire you at the Metro Court.
And what did she say?
That I should be an agent. I can't sing, but I can sell.
Seriously?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, that is great.
Lulu, you're awesome.
Well, it's not a lock, but, you know, she wants to talk to you, so.
Well, hey, that, I guess you can have some wine.
Thank you. Oh, my God. Wow, you can really cook. This is incredible.
Oh, thank you. But actually, Dante helped me.
Yeah, right.
I did. I did. I remembered the secret recipe.
But let me tell you, it's only because his Nona, she stole that recipe from my grandmother. It's
wow.
Ours.
Actually, yeah. My Nona got it from her mother who brought it over from the old country.
No.
It's not making cinnamon.
Oh, look at that. Nice going, idiot. Now it's not a secret anymore.
All right, don't mind us. This is just an old Bensonhurst feud. Needless to say, we both equally created this amazing meal. Here, you want some cheese?
Oh, this is what I like, a man who waits on me. So, anyway, Brooke, if Carly asked you to audition, you would, right?
Yeah, of course. I would do anything, so.
I was just telling Brooke that, if she decides to stick around, that would make three people in this great town that don't want to spit on me.
Oh, of course. It's all about you.
Yes.
I'm actually really impressed with the meal. It was good.
Well, thank you.
Did you do the...
For once.
Did you make the garlic?
I made the garlic.
No, the garlic bread.
I made the bread, too, and then I put the garlic bread on it.
Wait, are you leaving? No, Dante, tell her she can't leave.
Okay, you don't have to go.
Actually, I do, because if I'm going to stay in town, I have to take care of a lot of things. Plus, if I'm going to impress Carly, I'm going to need my rest. And this was supposed to be a dinner for two, so.
Well, it was great having you here. And it was fun tearing up the kitchen together.
I left it a mess.
Oh, my gosh, you did plenty. Just... Don't even worry about it. Call me tomorrow.
I will. And thank you so much for talking to Carly. I'm not sure how I'm going to thank you, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to think of something. So.
Okay.
All right. Bye.
Bye.
Have a nice night.
See ya.
Don't you love it, how things work out? I mean, Kate's hissy fit put me right where I needed to be to run into Carly, and now Brooke might be able to stay in Port Charles for a while. Wouldn't that be wonderful? You know, I cannot believe Brooke made such a good meal with no recipe, making it up as she went along.
You know what she's like? My mother, and all the other falconry women and Cirilla women I grew up with, they... cooking is like breathing to them.
And the boys learn how to play stickball and teach themselves how to wait on people hand and foot.
And, keep their women happy.
Oh, I see. So picket lines have been passed down for generations.
Well, you know, there's more to happiness than I could pick up on.
Guess my